every day when I wake up. I can see His mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, His plans for me is to succeed.
Well, grace and peace and good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair. What a joy and what a privilege it is to begin a brand new day with you. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and I will be glad in it. Let me remind you of our theme verse of scripture taken from Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse 23. The mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and I. Every day we wake up, it is a day that God has blessed us with. And on this Sunday, we're excited about this day, a day for worship, a day for gleaning and growing as we collectively, whether we're online or whether we are in person, a day where we can give God praise and a day where we can give God the glory with our brothers and our sisters. For those of you that are connected to Greater Faith, of course, Bishop James Edwell will be with us this morning, and we're looking to have a wonderful time in the presence of the Lord. We have been in this faith series for quite some time, talking about faith, believing for faith, and again, this weekend, I challenge you to release your faith for something that God will do for you this weekend. And you still have time. You still have time. So if you're like me, sometimes I look at Sunday as the first day of the week. And then sometimes I look at Sunday as the last day of the weekend. And Monday is the first day of the week. So you still have time to exercise your faith. Let's go back to 2 Peter chapter number 1 and verse number 5. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse number 5. The Bible says these words. And besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue. Add to your faith virtue. Giving all diligence, add to your faith. Giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue. First thing I want to share with you, for those that are taking notes, he uses the language of giving all diligence. Diligence deals with effort. It deals with not just effort, but a concentrated, consistent effort in a particular way or toward a particular goal or a task. When someone is diligent in their task, they are considerate of details. They are considerate of the effort and the energy that they are putting behind whatever it is that they're going after. And so Peter says, when it comes to your faith, be diligent regarding your faith. Be diligent regarding what God has in store for you. Be diligent regarding the effort that you take. And here's what he says. Be diligent to add to your faith virtue. He says, add to your faith virtue. Yesterday, we talked about adding action to our faith. As a reminder, Peter takes it a step further and says, add to your faith virtue. Now, for those that are taking notes, I want you to write this down. The word virtue here is defined as a virtuous course of thought, feeling, or action. A virtuous course of thought, feeling, and action. Now, often we think in terms of faith and action and corresponding action and having conviction and persuasion and all of that, all of the things that we've been talking about, and that is true. But sometimes we are not in faith as we should be because our feelings have gotten in the way. It hasn't happened as quickly as we thought it should have. What we're waiting on, it hasn't happened. Or maybe something has happened, but it didn't happen the way we thought it was going to happen. And so our feelings are in the way. Sometimes we're looking at other people get blessed and they're coming into their own and the grace of God on their life is increasing. Their business is taking off and this one has gotten married and this other one is on vacation and this one just got a new house and this one looks like, you know, they came into, you know, a financial increase, but it hasn't happened for me. And so I'm in my feelings. Well, feelings can cause you to forfeit your faith. Someone put that in the chat area. Feelings can cause me to forfeit my faith. Because he tells me, add to my faith virtue. Add to my faith virtuous thinking, feelings, and a course of action. And so today, I want you to check your feelings regarding what you are going after. Are you anxious? Are you depressed? Are you stressed out regarding what you are praying for and believing God for? You're in faith, but your feelings are a little antsy. You know, Lord, when is it going to happen? A little frustrated. I'm a little timid. You know, I'm not asking, you know, with bold faith. You know, I'm just saying, you know, Lord, if it be your will, you know, have my feelings caused me to forfeit my faith? Because I need to add to my faith this thing called virtue, which is a virtuous course of thinking, a virtuous course of feeling and action. So I need to get my thoughts right. I need to get my feelings right so that I can act right. I want to say that again. I need to get my thoughts right so I can get my feelings right so that I can act right. I hope this makes sense. As we're adding to our faith, we're adding and making sure that our course of thinking is right. In other words, as I'm waiting on God, how am I thinking regarding what I'm believing God for? Am I saying I'm believing, but also thinking that it's impossible? Am I believing that God's going to do it, but I'm frustrated? And so my feelings now have gotten me jilted regarding what I'm praying for and believing God for. I'm here to suggest to you, add to your faith a virtuous course of thinking. Add to your faith the right feelings and add to your faith the right actions. And God willing, God be our help and strength. I will see you in the morning. God bless. The gospel. This is the good news. Tell everybody how he saved you. This is the gospel. Come here, the good news. Tell everybody. There's a God that loves you. Oh, how he loves you. There's a God that loves you.